Launch sequence complete.
Thank you, and please visit again.
Engaged.
Due to inactivity, we have been forced to assign your LAN in search of another customer. Please proceed to assigned landing bay. Incomplete. Have a pleasant stay.
Communications off. Weapon system off.
Riker Memorial Spaceport, servicing the Greater Area 18 metropolitan area. We hope you have safe travels wherever your final destination may be.
Thank you.
Right, do you want some? I can make you some. What have you done?
We're sorry. You've exceeded the allotted time to depart. You'll have to return your ship to storage. Initiating ship storage procedure. For your safety, please maintain the area. Thank you for your cooperation. For your safety, please vacate the area. Thank you for your cooperation.
with a round-the-clock assistant available for the medical unit, you can schedule your bed, day, or night.
Your ship has been delivered to the following landing pad.
Please be aware that while in the Stanton system and on ArcCorp, all UEE common laws are still in effect.
You are clear to launch. Thank you, and please visit again.
Thank you.
assigned landing bay. Incomplete. Have a pleasant stay.
Weapon system off.
Thank you.
are clear to launch.
Sequence complete.
Thank you, and please visit again.
Forever getting lost in this place. So easy to take a wrong turn.
Owen.
Hurston, yeah. Did you go to ArtCorp then? How did you find that with all the neon signs and...
Kind of funky.
Yeah, it's like our whole city planet.
Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
I quite like actually the fact that you have to get a sky bus or a metro or whatever to get to places. It kind of gives it a more, like, a lot of people were like critical when it first came out. They were saying, you know, why do I want to play the London Underground? But yeah, it's a pretty cool idea. And, like, I like the fact that they've made different design choices as well, like in Hurston. You know, it's a really dirty old monorail, whereas in ArtCorp it's like a fancy sky bus. Like, flies through. Just got the sun coming up behind all the smoggy big buildings. It's so good. I can see that when they finalize this, there's going to be people addicted to, like, living inside Star Citizen, like in Ready Player One or something.
turret.
Landing complete. Have a pleasant stay.
I think it's just, there's probably a bad guy out there, like a griefer or something. Yeah, there's something about the design ethic of Star Citizen, it's a bit gritty. Kind of reminds me of, like a mix of Battlestar Galactica and, called? Starship Troop. Sorry, mate, what were you saying? Yeah, it's got like all the sort of nods to Star Trek and Star Wars, and even a bit Alien as well. Oof. Yeah, it can be a bit buggy. The only thing I can't remember to do is how to scroll the camera in and out during external view. Have you figured that out yet?
No, I've always found the auto view quite reasonable to be honest. I'm not bothered. Sweet, made $2,000 on that scrap run.
Yeah, the scrap runs are quite profitable. I don't know whether they scrap old ships or what.
window. Okay, there's a turret firing at your ship.
Oh, I'm just writing a message to Gary, actually. But I'm on my way to Port Olazar. It's just, we just exchange messages now and then, because I know he's had to do more hours or something. Yeah, some of them can be pay out pretty well. So have you tried, what ships have you tried so far? Your Mustang and your Freelance.
Yeah, I like the Freelance.
Yeah, Freelance is good fun, isn't it? I mean, that was the first ship I sort of splurged money. Because I think I saw a demonstration of them like landing on a planet with it, and I was like, that looks like my Millennium Falcon.
We're sorry.
Or more like a Lone Star from Spaceballs. Whatever it was called. You know, the Winnebago with wings? Please tell me you've seen Spaceballs. Spaceballs, the comedy that's like a ripoff of Star Wars, yeah. That's the one. They're jamming the radar. Yeah, they say eventually you'll be able to hire NPC crew as well, which would be quite
cool. For your safety, please vacate the area. Thank you for your cooperation.
So then you can have like an NPC turret and things like that. So have you been in any done any combat missions yet?
Only the practice dogfight.
Your ship has been delivered to the following landing pad.
Because that Mustang, I forgot to tell you, you can buy 2 size 1 weapons to put on the side. Did you ever play Elite Dangerous at all?
I didn't like it. I literally opened it and was like, this is shit, and never touched it again.
Yeah, I played it a lot when it first came out, and then I kind of found it a bit too grindy, so I kind of... But, you do go through... Yeah, you go through a phase of being super... super geeky with learning all the guns and things like that, and it gets a bit like that with Star Citizen as well.
Drop cargo onto the floor and stuff.
If you got like a mission box?
Yeah, it's like a big yellow box that I'm carrying around with me.
I think if you press F, you should be given the option to drop your cargo, drop what you're holding. I've never done it myself.
Okay. Stop getting in the bed! Oh my god!
Yeah, there's someone in red just sat on the pad next to the pad I've just been given, which is a bit alarming, because that usually means they're a pirate. Or they have a crime stat or something.
You were being shot at? If you could get out of bed like you're not on a Sunday morning coffee break, that'd be great, thank you. I take it your ship is locked, so only you can get in and out of there.
Yeah, that should be the way it is. But what happens is sometimes people try and jump in whilst you're not looking. So, like, if you leave your ramp down and you piss around doing something. Great. Yeah, there's a turret trying to shoot someone. And he's hitting the ship behind as well. I'm the freelancer just landing.
Warning, you are blocking an active flight bane. Please vacate the vicinity. Initiating ship storage procedure. For your safety, please vacate the area. Thank you for your cooperation.
Yeah, I need to go inside and drop my car.
Initiating ship storage procedure. For your safety, please make it to area. Thank you for your cooperation.
What the hell? Literally just threw me back into the space station.
Where do you need to go with that parcel?
Your ship has been delivered to the following landing pad.
Ship called Lyra.
Okay.
For your convenience, our automated ship
So do you want me to come in the ship with you, or do you want me to fly escort with you?
Let's go together, aren't we?
Yep, okay. I'll just be there in a sec. Do you remember which pad you're on? What pad number you're on?
B01.
It's quite a good scrap run. So with a full freelancer, I think it was 9 grand to fill it. And now I have 12 grand.
Nice.
So it's about 3 grand profit. It's not bad.
Well, that's annoying. If you leave the game, then your mission track goes.
Oh yeah, your ship's disappeared.
Oh yeah, you need to join my part.
I think so.
From the main menu?
Dunno. Yeah, maybe. I can't seem to find it on like Moby Glass anywhere. I'm
Your ship has been delivered to the following landing pad.
A02. What the hell is A02?
Oh yeah, also you can customize your ship, so if you own like two ships, you can take the guns off one ship and put them on.
That's cool.
So that's quite handy, yeah. So like if I wanted to upgrade my Freelancer to have Gatling guns instead of the cannons, I only have to buy one because I already have three on other ships. But that does mean then you can't use them on that other ship.
Oh, fair
enough. So should I log out or something then? To join your party?
I'll let you log back in and create a party. Parcel I had is still on my ship. Right, I'm firing up. I'll be waiting for you.
Yeah, it's weird because I've just got my contact list and then I can invite you to a party.
Yeah.
But I can't join a party. Are you receiving anything when I click invite to party? That's weird, because the other day you were already in game when I joined you, weren't you?
I think so.
You are clear to launch.
Otherwise it just gives me a join friends button, which is what I used to get to you originally.
Thank you, and please visit again.
Whilst it's loading, I'll have a quick read.
What I'll do then is I'll jump to this destination and drop this package off, and then what I'll do is I'll log out and we'll both log back in together, see if that works.
Yeah, if you... Is it just a moon of Olizar?
No, it's some... It's quite far off, actually.
Yeah, the only thing is you might lose your ship, and you'll have to reclaim it, so it takes a bit of time to come back to Olizar. But that's okay, we can always use one of my... Yeah, okay, no worries.
Thank you. but it won't let me plan a route. It still needs to go to R&R, L1.
Yeah, and then when you go there, you have to then go inside a building, and there'll be like a parcel delivery vending machine. Good question. You should have a fuel gauge in the cockpit somewhere. If not, use your Mobi glass to have a look. When you plan your routes, it'll tell you how much quantum fuel you're going to use and how much you have left. But otherwise, you have to buy some to reload.
Proceed to assigned landing bay.